The theme of this conference is, are we getting connected? And one way of getting connected is by using your own language and your own culture. And so we're going to introduce, for our final session, three more speakers who will tell them about how they present their culture, their language and their region. And the first one we have here is from Omroep Fryslân. Her name is Jacqueline Spendel, and she's going to present her work.
Thank you. Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you for coming here. I'm a project manager at Omroep Fryslân, and I would like to tell you something about two small projects we do this year, and we do these projects different than what we used to. But before I tell you about these two little projects, I want to show you what we do all year round in the projects in our region. This is a summary.
Het is de dag van de start van het scootersion.
Bart Helmholt, die hebt hier zijn allerlaatste FK.
Goedemorgen.
Hoe is het?
Ja, je hebt gewoon bijt, joh.
Ja.
Dat een graaidekuier tussen de tiende blommen, het franjekroet en het skippeneer superieur is aan een stedskuier tussen CNA, Douglas en McDonald's.
Nou, wij staan clear voor de start. Het is een
We zijn de eerste 12 kilometer al voorbij. Dus dat zit lekker op.
Waar is Miranda? Is Miranda al onderweg?
Hey! Hey, maar en ben jij al een hele kloof in hellen?
Ja, ik denk dat ik nou misschien een 100 van me had, dus dan ga ik al 1400 te pakken.
Hoppakee.
Dus aankletten met die handel. Ja, is er ook.
Nog 15 seconden. Nog 15. Nou, dan tellen we mij mooi. 15.
10, 9. The sun hits like a bullet of fate, and then suddenly I'm wide awake.
Ik begin wel een beetje wat te feel hier en daar. Ja, maar ik wil even heel eerlijk in wijzen.
Ja, goed. Uit. Oh, en dan is het nog. De winning is waar het Jan in de Groot ziet. Misschien in van de PC.
Dat voorbij is.
Wie een mooie dag, maar muziek, maar cultuur, maar sfeer, maar pracht.
Fantastisch.
Well, as you can see, we do a lot of different projects. Most of them are for a large group of Frisians who enjoy to be there or to enjoy watching us or follow us live. But this year we made a different choice in two small projects we do. And the difference is the project we normally do, we are going somewhere, we are making live reports, or we interview people. But what we do right now with these two things, it's a festival and an exhibition. We are being a part of it. So we participate in the projects and become viewers and visitors of these specific festivals and exhibitions are going to see us also. And I have two examples I would like to show you. The first one is Oranjewoud Festival. This is their own logo. The Oranjewoud Festival is a festival where you can listen to classical music. And as you can see, the classical music you can enjoy in their grounds, in parks, and at country houses or in the woods. And what we did this year is make a film for the visitors to come and see. And of course, we have a goal with that, because we like people to see us in a different place. Because the people who come to visit such a festival are not coming for us, but they are coming to enjoy music and everything that surrounds the music. But what we do there is that people see us in a different way, and we can surprise them and give them something to enjoy. So we made a film of the nature surrounding the festival. And my colleague filmmaker, he made shots with this goose. And maybe you think it's a real goose, but it's not. It's a plastic one. And he put some cameras on it to make shots underwater and above water. And here he is putting it into it. And he made some lovely shots. I will show you in a minute. It's nice to know that the other gooses in the water, they didn't even see the difference. So he could come very, very close. This is the trailer I want to show you. It's without a voiceover, because the voiceover was in Frisian. I don't think you all understand it. So, but it gives you an idea of what we are making there. This is a teaser we already are broadcasting. At this moment, the film is edited, because it will have his start in the festival at the 1st of June. It's about 15 minutes we show the people there, and they can enter it for free. And of course, what we want to achieve there is that people are saying, wow, is this what Omroep Gelderland is making? I want to know more of them. And of course, they can find us on the website and see large or small extensions of this film. Another example I have with me is another project. It's called Frisians Abroad. And Frisians Abroad, it has the same idea. We are being part of an exhibition. Both of these projects are part of Cultural Capital this year. And what you see is a ship where the exhibition is. You can see it just 7 minutes walk from here. And in the exhibition, what is about the past, present, and future of Friesland and of Leeuwarden, you can also see our homesick house, they call it. We've asked Frisians all over the world, and maybe this is interesting for you, because you all have your own Frisians abroad. You all have people from your own country living somewhere around the globe doing something different. And what we did is we made a mojo project of this. My colleague filmmaker made shots here in Friesland and asked the Frisians abroad to do the same there about their lives. And they uploaded it to us. And we interviewed them via Skype and FaceTime. And the overall question and subject was, when are the moments you long to be back home? When do you want to go back to Friesland again? And what do you do about it? I'd like to show you the first a small piece of one of the portraits. It's Karst, and he's living in China right now, and he tells and shows us something about his life. So this is all mojo. Thank you.
Tuskas Dreisma, ik ben van T-Cirk. Ik ben hier nu in China, in het plakje Aishamen. En achter mij is Giggling Tree, het guesthouse waar wij zo'n 2006 mijn familie wijnen.
Ja, als je zelfs flexibel bent en nog hebben om zijn avontuur om te gaan, dan is het wel een norm waar je wel dingen van kennen. Dat mensen vragen, ja, welkom zijn, dat is wel in Friesland. Dus dat is wel een groot deel van de identiteit, maar ik denk dat het wel meer is. In ons gezin praten wij nog Nederlands. Wij in het buitenland, Nederlands is dan de eerste poort om al Nederlandse gasten. Maar voor mezelf, ze draaien me mee met vrijheid, dan praat je stedfries of echt tot Noorsfries. Ja, dat kun je wel heel makkelijk vinden. Nee, bij ons echt, maar het gevoel komt wel dichterbij als je in het Fries praat. Zelfs mensen in een bepaalde moment in de familie dat het iets minder gaat, mensen ziek binnen, mensen die overlijden en dat hebben we recent voor in mei maken. Ja, dan zit je toch wel heel veel voet om dan emotioneel vieren toch van, ja, we moeten daarin, we moeten eigenlijk bij uw familie wezen. Van Paulien en ja, dan krijg ik weer een bericht van ja, je weet dat het net zo goed is, maar dat het toch wel slim ziek is. Ja, dan is het eigenlijk zo gauw mogelijk de zaken waar je dat voor me overbrengen dat het als je wijk is. En, want dan was het gewoon een hoes. Zoals met alle contacten denk ik, als je vier punten binnen, echt met vreun skippen. Op een gegeven moment alleen maar de echte hichtepunt of de echte dieptepunt. En dat denk ik van dij tot dij. Die ja, vaak het meeste tijd die nemen bij je emoties echt insteren. Ja, die dingen die, als er 10 dagen alleen iets gebeurd is, dan krijg je die dingetjes net bij mij. He? En dan is het minder van, ja, die is ziek, of die is beter, of die had de been gekregen, of die is verhuizen. He? Dus dan wisselen we op de echte, maar de emotie van het moment, die krijg je net niet. Die afstand, ja, die creëert daarmee echt een bepaalde vervlakking.
Yeah, this was a small piece of the portrait of Karst. We've got 10 more from Frisians abroad in Norway, in Melbourne, in China, like he is, in France, Portugal, all over the globe. So if you want to see them, which I hope, because you have a free afternoon tomorrow, I understand, you can go. It's 7 minutes walk to the park. All these things you see are parts of bigger projects of cultural capital. This is called the Pavilion Leeuwarders, Pavilion Leeuwarden. And you can see the small portraits there. And I hope it will be a huge success. From the Oranjewoud Festival, I don't know anything yet because it has to start. But in this case, I know it's been open for 6 weeks. More than 15,000 people have already visited the pavilion and also saw our films. I'm a frequent visitor myself, and I always ask the volunteers who work there, what did they say about the exhibition and what did they say about us? Did they see us? And yes, they did see us, and they left comments, and most of them were really flattering and helpful to do what we do best, making lovely content. But show us to another audience, showing to visitors who do not expect us, but hey, we are here, come and follow us. Thank you.
Thank you, Jacqueline. We're going to do the same drill as we did with the social projects, so I'm going to ask you to stand beside. And we'll have our next speaker, and then another one, and then we'll go to the questions. But our next speaker is from Spain, and she's going to tell us about the events and the culture of her region. Her name is Maria Teresa, but we can call her Matey. So, from TPA Asturias. Go ahead.
Okay, my name is Maite Cardin. I come on behalf of the radio television of the Principality of Asturias, and I'm going to make a brief introduction of our company and our activity. Asturias has a population about 1,035,000 inhabitants and an area of 10,602 square kilometers. The Asturias television and the radio began broadcasting in 2006. Currently, both have joined in to fund the corporation Radio Television, RTPA, which has been operating for 12 years. The RTPA activity is completed with the web and with the presence in social networks. Okay. Okay. RTPA has an annual budget of around 20 million euro. In 2017, the television had an annual average audience share of 5.1. Sorry, I'm very nervous. Okay. With respect to the audience share of 6.2% of the 11 organisms belonging to FOTA, the Spanish Federation of Regional Radio and Television Organism. Okay. RTPA was created and designed as a television and radio of proximity by and for Asturians. The programming was as a whole reflects the identity symbols of the region. The fundamental purpose is to inform about current affairs and to make known and promote its tradition and culture. Information program at the basis of the programming. However, RTPA produces entertainment programs and live and deferred transmission of various kinds of events. In this graphic, you can see how the budget for the production of contents is allocated to the production of information contents, to the production of programs, and to broadcasting events, only the 7.2%. Okay. The broadcasts are largely in-house production or production order, some on a very low budget, and produced with simple technical means. In spite of the low budget, a high profitability is obtained in terms of audience or public service. In 2017, we have produced a total of 162 broadcasting events, which are over 260 hours of broadcast. Okay. The channel has played high stakes on the live broadcastings with the aim to connecting with the society and the territory. Moreover, they are a clear example of programs which reflect and add value to the current events of the region, as well as the tradition and culture of Asturias. There are programs of unpublished content which have never been seen on television previously and which enable all the inhabitants to share and enjoy events of interest to all the community within a region as small in size but geographically extremely dispersed. The following video shows a few examples of broadcasting.
Thank you.
Okay, we have compiled the following selection of some of the best broadcasts, reflecting the variety of typology of our of the production. The first example is about the Exemplary Town Award. This is the award which the Princess of Asturias Foundation dedicates to the region. It is awarded to the town, village, or group of Asturias which has excelled in its defense and conservation of its natural surrounding environment and its historical, cultural, and artistic heritage. This is the most complicated broadcast we carry out, due to the strict norms of the Royal House and the difficulty of working in location with poor infrastructure. Okay, I have to say that the Queen Leticia is originally from Asturias. Okay. The next video is about the competition and display of folklore city of Oviedo. This event is dedicated. A ver, wait a momento. No. Sorry. I was out. The next video is about the mass in Covadonga. Our national holiday, the Day of Asturias, is the feast of the Virgin of Covadonga, patron of the region. The solemn mass is celebrated in the Basilica of Covadonga in the presence of thousands of people and authorities. Now. Okay, the next video is about a competition and display of folklore city of Oviedo. This event is dedicated to Asturian traditional music. It is celebrated from October to June, and apart from the performance of the most important artists in the genre, there is a competition for a new performance in different categories.
Siendo el casar
rastres el agua negro. Yo ya
Okay, the next video is about a concert called Spirum. Spirum is the name of the show offered by the Villa of Gijón Pipe Band. The bagpipe is the traditional instrument of Asturias, and this is an example of the fusion between the traditional sound of the pipe and other modern instruments and sounds. This video is about a concert of Victor Manuel. Perhaps Victor Manuel is the region's most important singer. Many of his songs are dedicated to themes related to Asturias. However, he has been and continues to be a benchmark performer to the Spanish music scene. In 2014, a concert tribute to his 50 years as a performer was held in Oviedo, in which many important Spanish performers participated.
Asturias, si yo pudiera, si yo supiera cantarte, Asturias, verde de montes y negra de
Okay, now I'm going to show you some examples of events, the traditional festivals. The first one is about one called La Descarga. This is an interesting and astonishingly popular festival which is celebrated in honor of the Virgin of the Carmen. At 8 o'clock in the evening, thousands of firecrackers of all sizes are set off, and the evening sky darkens for 10 minutes amid the deafening noise. Thousands of people stand out every year to enjoy the show. Okay. The next video is called Pastry Festivals. On Easter Sunday, the Pastry Festival is celebrated in Avilés. The name comes from a peculiar type of pastry which dozens of people eat on this day in the streets of the city. A long procession of floats, band of music, and folkloric groups parade through the streets of the city.
Thank you.
Okay, now it's an example of what we call the Three Kings Cavalcade. The festivity of the Three Kings is one of the most outstanding at Christmas in Spain. On the evening of January 5, in all the cities of the country, cavalcades with the Three Kings bearing gifts for children. Since regional television has existed in Asturias, the cavalcade has been broadcasted in all the major cities in the region.
¿Qué tan espectacular como el
disfrutar de la cabalgata?
Es un largo.
Okay, and now some examples of sports. The first one is about bowling. Bowling is the community's most traditional game and deeply rooted in the popular culture of Asturias. A bowling federation has existed since 1962, and it boasts dozens of bowling clubs throughout the community. In Asturias, there is a huge interest in cycling. The Tour of Asturias is one of the most beautiful and difficult races held in the country. This is the most costly of all the broadcasts we cover. Okay, and the last one is called the International Descent of the River Sella. The International Descent of the Sella is the most important sports competition in the region. It's a canoeing competition which runs the length of 15 kilometers of the River Sella. The competition has been held since the year 1931. Okay, all these programs can be watched online and are available on video on demand in our web. And this is my presentation. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. You really like your party in Asturias. Why don't you join Jacqueline on the back? Maybe they have some questions later, have something to drink. And for us, it's time for our last speaker of the day. From the Netherlands, from Omroep Gelderland, we have Guido Lavalaye. Last name going wrong. Yeah, you can use that. And after that, we have some questions, and then you're all released. So,
Lavalaye. Is everybody still awake? So I'm going to keep it short and tell you something about the cultural events at Omroep Gelderland. Just to start, this is me. I'm kind of born at Omroep Gelderland and worked there all my life. I started as a reporter, and I'm now in charge of information and projects, so the large and minor reports all included. If am I going too fast, just ask. This is something about Omroep Gelderland and the region of Gelderland. If you get in a car and go down for 1 hour, you're at Gelderland, beautiful province. Omroep Gelderland is like 130 people working over there, just to get an impression. The information projects are about 18, 20 people working there, making a lot of online, little TV, and a lot of radio. For events, we've got some categories. Not really on paper, but more in the head. Well, if there's something going, like an event, this is how we go there. Just make an article, or make just a short story, make video item, cameo, maybe Mojo sometimes, and a social. Sometime an Instagram for Elkana.
In Apeldoorn wordt vandaag de 9e editie van het Zeepkistenrace Festival gehouden. Er is echt van alles te doen. Een theaterweide, een kabelbaan, bubbelvoetbal en natuurlijk een zeepkistenrace. Want daar gaat het om. Maar willen die kinderen dat tegenwoordig eigenlijk nog wel? Want ze zitten toch veel liever achter een tablet, PlayStation of telefoon? Ik ga het uitzoeken.
Vader nog even verrassen, die zit tegelijkertijd aan het film van Utrecht.
Watch it all, it's about 2 minutes. Just have some fun with kids in small built cars. See the next. Then we're going, it's a bit bigger. We make a live registration from an event. We do this more and more because public loves it. If you go live and show it. 1 minute of flowers.
Editie van het Bloemencorso in Lichtenvoorde.
Ten or maybe 20 times a year we've got these events and go out. Then there's a category a bit bigger, about 10 times a year. Is really huge, and like all everyone is going out for us and work and help at the Vierdaagse.
Duitsland?
Ja, die wonen aan de overkant.
Ik was niet meer te stoppen.
En ligt dat nou aan uw genen of aan uw doorzettingsvermogen? Wat denkt u?
Het was deze keer karakter.
That was it. I do really have only one message, and I think it's that these culture events are of major importance for our channels, and I think everybody agrees with that. It's a good way to connect with our audience. We see the trend that more live and just be there and show, we're doing that more and more. And it's always a combination from news and information and always just laugh, some fun, and that's it.